having these companies, and role of directors like Mazu, Zuresh Anagalli, Nagari, and so many people, to Achara, to many, many people, and even from Kerala, Joseph, settled in Karnataka after going to Nina Saman. He's become a Kannadiga right now. Sangutti does a lot of productions in Karnataka. A lot of people are doing, migrating to Karnataka for doing productions. So that's, he'll be doing that. And how, when it becomes a repertory company, how the production changes, what about aesthetics, how and what is just urban cities to the rural places, how it is going to be taken, prepared, all those things are there. It's actually a big area to discuss with. And so those things Basu will be speaking, and we have got a lot of people from Karnataka also here, and they can also interact and give their suggestions and opinions and make this a very lively kind of discussions. So before handing it out to Basu, I just briefly introduce Basu. It's not needed because this is personally known to everybody. We call him Basu. He's Basu Lingayya, Z Basu Lingayya, an alumni of National School of Drama, and he has come back and in theater after NSD. He has come back and started doing theater. Before going to NSD, he has done his PG in Kannada literature. Then he started doing theater. He became the director of Rangayana, a very important center, and he has worked a long time there in building up the institution. It was such a vibrant. Then the National School of Drama started a research center, South Indian theater in Bangalore, and he was again the director of that center, which later became a center of National Drama itself. Their academies started. He is the director of NSD Bangalore center right now. And Lisa is keeping up with, yes, been involved in doing theater all over Karnataka, I'll say. And he has done a lot of productions, and many important productions he has done in Kannada, Hindi, Telugu, Assamese, and also in Malayalam. I don't know which is the Malayalam play which he directed, but he'll tell that. And now, Malamagali Madhumagalu, I makes that Malamagali Madhumagalu is one of the major productions, one of the events, I'll make it like that, that happened in Kannada theater for the last many years. It's a big production where around 100 or more actors, 75 actors, I think, plus other technicians are joining to that for a single production. And it covers a big area. It's not happening in a proscenium stage. Many stages are there, many venues are there. It's a kind of open air, environmental, whatever term you can put in. And it's a mega production running 9 hours. The duration of the play is 9 hours. And that play has been repeatedly shown every year for the last many, many years. 109 shows are over. That was 109 shows that happened last year. 109 shows and over, and for every show, 1,000 or more people are watching it, and they're paying a ticket of, for the last time it was 1,000 rupees per head. So people are paying, 1,000 people are paying 1,000 rupees for a single show, and 109 shows. So more than lakhs of people have seen it. And that's an event. When Basu announces this play is going to happen, there's a big buzz around it. And the full night show, that's an event that's happened. And the Basu is known for such mega productions. So it's done mega productions before also. And this Malamagale is based on the Kuvempu novel. It's The Bride of the Mountains. And these other productions are Gandhi versus Gandhi, Kusumabale, The Road, Shudra Tapaswi, Tipuna Kanasagalu, The Dreams of Tipuhutan, King Oedipus, Jengamada, what's it? Jengamada Dege.
Jengamada Dege.
Jengamada Dege.
Jengamada Dege.
even if I have done four productions in Karnataka, sometimes the Kannada words are still having a problem on my tongue. So this is productions is he has won the Kannada Nadaka Academy Award and the prestigious Kannada Rajyotsava Award. And he's a wonderful teacher. He's an expert in the folk tradition of the small folk traditions to larger production traditions in the whole of South India. And he's open to what is happening in Indian theater. He's a good academic and a very loving teacher and a good friend. So that's a very brief introduction about Basu. So with this, we'll leave to Basu for the first talk, and we'll follow with an introduction. As you know, when you are interfering or asking a question, or please give me your name. Give the name also so that we want your name when this text is going to be transcribed and this is going to be published into a book. So we need a very dynamic interaction with the participation of everybody. So welcome to everybody, and welcome next Sunday also with Rubojida Gogoi from Guwahati on ethnic theatres of Northeast. So over to you, Basu.
Thank you, Chandradasan. Good morning to everybody. I'm pleased to have you people. A little bit nervous also. This kind of Zoom meeting I never addressed. One more thing, I'm talking about the alien language. That is not my mother tongue. English is not my mother tongue. But India have a problem with many, because India is, we always say politically, is the one nation. But many nations included is the one nation. That's what our great first Jnanapitha was, the poor profession. Sarva Janangada Sundara Tota. It's a lot of many religion, culture, language, and presence. And also, you say that Karnataka is such a nation. Bharata Jananiya Tanujate. Bharata is a nation. The Karnataka is there. Like that, we have. And one more thing, my Kannada language, I have a friendly relations with the border area, like that. What we felt is the one womb of mother, like Dravidian languages. Tamil is the, we know all the Tamil literature is the most ancient, they say that. After that, the Kannada will come. Later on, the Malayalam and Telugu like that. And also, Kannada declared as a classical language, government of India, we know that. So, like many classical languages, Kannada has been recognized. And in Kannada, many people, if you go anywhere in the nook and corner of the Karnataka, in the school or public places, you can see the 8 photographs, portrait of Jnanapitha Wadi, that is there. The Kannadigas, everybody tried, going from Kuvempu to Dr. Chandrasekhar Kampa, the Kannada literature awarded the 8 Jnanapitha Prashasti. And we have 3 Rashtra Kavis awarded by Government of Karnataka. The first Kavi is from nearer to Kasaragod, that is Govindappa. He's our first national poet, we declare like Tagore and Kuvempu. The second Rashtra Kavi is K.V. Puttappa, Kuvempu. The third one, G.S. Surudrappa. G.S. Surudrappa is a student of Kuvempu. So why I'm telling that, these are all the things to make Kannadiga alone. Can you hear me? Is it audible?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yeah, that's right. I'm talking about my language. Like that, in our neighboring state, Tamil Nadu, Telugu, and including Malayalam, we have a relationship with the cultural relationship. If Kathakali is there in Kerala, or Kudiyattam is there, apparently we have a Yakshagana there, two types of Yakshagana. If it is a Thayam is there in Malayalam, we have a Bhutaradhana, Sriyaradhana like that. So the entire India, the great two narratives, you know, Mahakavya, what we say, Ramayana, Mahabharata, the great epic, the one more Ramakatha, Krishnakatha, the narrated coastal region of Karnataka. That's what Yakshagana always mentions, financed Assam. And this Yakshagana influenced even Marathi theatres in the beginning. I'm talking about really Kannada theater. If you go to the Sasana, the inscription of the language, if you go back to 9th century back, the first poet, we call that Adikavi Pampa. Pampa, Ranna, Panna. There was a literary game. We call that the Adikavi. Pampa is the first propellant. He is in Jain in the region, but he written in Kannada. That's why we always quote Pampa to Kuvempu. That's a great, because there are in that we have one more literary book called Kaviraja Marga. In Kaviraja Marga, the poet explains where the language spread out at Ayaza. Southern plateau, you know, Deccan plateau, what he says. That Kaveri Godavari is the Nadu Kannada, Janapadali say that. And it means we have a intercultural relation between Kannada and neighboring states. That's why many states in colonial rule, we know that Calcutta, Mumbai, Chennai, that directly affected. All the cultural activities start there only. But whereas our capital city, Bangalore, it is not a cultural center for us. We would say in Kannada also, there were many Kannadas, not one single Kannada. That's why we called in the northern part, Hyderabad, Nizam area, when Karnataka became unified after independence. The, all these four regions became one. In the 60s only, he is named as a, first it is a Mysore state. The Mysore belongs to Chennai, you know, is a Madras region, we say that. The Hyderabad Karnataka, it means Hyderabad Karnataka, it means nearby Nizam. And one more thing is a Karavali, coastal region, like that. So Bangalore is no identity. Now, last two decades, Bangalore became an international icon for the ITBC sector. But till today, we never, I born from Bangalore city one day, but I won't firmly believe that the Bangalore is the cultural center. But you have many cultural centers. That's why if you have that Dharwada, Mysore, Mangaluru, even Chitradurga, Ballari, these are all the cultural identity for Karnataka. Now, in a global village, what we call global village, our global village is Yangon. Through K.V. Subbanna, we made it entire globe to look towards a tiny village called Yangon. So, I'm talking today, the mainly three major repertory companies active last five decades. After independence, the first theatre school as well as theatre company who are in Yangon. So the vision is K.V. Subbanna. And K.V. Subbanna also, he made Kannada international pride when he got the Magsaysay Award. He's the first person in southern region for theatre activities, especially for what he done. He decentralized the Kannada culture as well as the theatre. He's a visionary. But he always say Subbanna and Akshara were all in, you know, some they usually say that. That is not just an individual contribution for that. It is a community. That's what Neelasam means, Neelakanteshwara Natya Seva Sangha. It is a village, there is a cooperative society based activities. They started with agriculture. So later on, Subbanna organized the entire village. In the 50s itself, they started Chitras Samaja, showing international world-known films to the village people. They can interact with those films. They know Sajit Ray, Ruchu Ghatak they know through the film. They can comment. So that was when globalization emerged. So already it has an alternative global village, K.V. Subbannaji and their team is created. So, and also the Anand Murthy is there, like that. Because K.V. Subbannaji is a student of, once again, Kuvempu. And Kuvempu is there in Mysore University. He's there as a rationalist, and also he politically, he is a socialist, Loyavada, Marxwada, everything he did. Finally, he always depicting his idea, the Egodu or Neelasam is not a single person's carbon, it's a community. That how the theater is also, it's a, theater is a composite art, but that was the legendary mark K.V. Subbanaji told us that. Even B.V. Karunji also always quote that, without K.V. Subbanaji and even Alkaji, his guru in Okarnath, you know, is the music guru. Karunji also always said that. But Karunji, he is also from South Kendra, Malnad region. But in childhood himself, he left his village, he joined Gubbi company. So we'll come later on. How the Kannada theater from colonial era to till modern era, how is it evolved? My subject is mainly today is focusing on repertory company. The word itself is not Indian, it's the alien part of repertory company. It's the best once again. So now the Kannada theater mainly, I'm not saying that we are going back to the root, cultural root, but we are interacting and negotiating with the world, with our art and culture, with the language, with the same language. That is the finest example is that in our state, the Neelasam did that. It's negotiated with the National School of Drama also. So that formula they taken, the idea they taken from National School of Drama only, of course, but it's purely a Kannada, the native expression of the art and culture. That's what K.V. Subbanna and the village. Now, K.V. Ekthara is leading that fantastically. He actually, before starting K.V. Subbanna, he started a publication of Akshara Prakashana. Tell that you can get world literature in all the world theater literature, it's available in Akshara Prakashana. Many wonderful books translated by Akshar himself, because he's also in the Alumni from Delhi. And one more thing, Subbanna vision, they carried out by three NSC graduates once again. Chidambar Rao Jambe, he is a senior of Akshar. Akshar also an alumni of NSC and localized. And even in the beginning, when they start, it's like a started as an amateur group in a group. It's a Neelasam. Later on, it's extended its program in many ways like that. That is the Tirupata. It's a semi-professional company. 1 year in the Rangasikshana Kendra, after training, they have a program of Tirugata. Tirugata is the company, it's a seasonal repetitive basis. The Tirugata means it's not taken in one place. They're traveling, it's like a traveling group. So this is also the inspiration taken from the Yakshagana. Till today, Yakshagana companies we have in South Kendra, every group, they were earlier booked 20 to 25 years. Because the seasonal repetitive like that, they tour around the South Kendra area. But that is also called a primitive repertory company for me, because the show always goes on. They were all a regular sponsorship for that, because doing Yakshagana, it is an, we call it as Arake Hata. The deity is there. Somebody, they prayer the god and they say that we will sponsor one Yakshagana. It's like that. Yeah, after, till today, they were quite active. All the group of Yakshagana in the summer season, they have it too. So that is the inspiration Neelasam taken. If you go to their website, you will get it. All the basic information, what is Ekoru and Tirugata, even that their Namuri Nahabha like that. There are many programs there. But initially, with the Kobo Nation here, they started Janaspandana, interacting with the local life, local culture. That was the beginning. Later on, government of Karnataka itself, they were supporting, they were taking help from the federal government, state government, but it's fully autonomous. But whereas if you compare with Rangayana, Rangayana's government started a repertory company, but in current regime and in Maya regime, Mayamana dynasty in Rangayana, we have a lot of freedom, but now it is not there. That all the bureaucracy ever there. Whereas in Engodu, there is their own society and the expression freedom is there. That's why it's a role model for Karnataka state, as well as national level also, as well as they have wonderful connections there nationally, internationally. That's why that is the one pride for the Kannada theatre culture, the goal. And you can see if you visit their website, there are 150 shows is available in YouTube. So one more thing, Neena, some of the great contribution, the impact made on Kannada theatre. All the graduates from Neena Sam, actually they offer the 1 year diploma course, the exam conducted by Higher Secondary Education Department. They were getting scholarship from the Department of Culture, but the pastoral students, somehow they taken care of their villages. That was Neena Sam the great, because it is not the city center, city concentrated what they do. They taken care to the rural area, the tiny villages, small villages. Even in small villages, we can get Neena Sam graduates. That was the impact in Kannada theatre. Now, many Rangayana's directors, they were from Neena Sam graduates like that. So that much impact Neena Sam Tirugata and the theatre students. Before this, I want to think that before coming modernity, we have a great legacy of company theatre. In northern part, they can't simply say that party theatre. But here we have a company theatre. Why the company theatre started? There is a very, very, very interesting thing that we have traditional theatre as well as ritualistic theatre and folk theatre like Yakshagana and ritualistic theatre. But modern theatre, we emerged mainly on after independence only. We call it as a 60. The pioneer of the modern theatre, who always specializing the company theatre module and directing, writing and directing the plays. That is, the first is Samsa, we call it. Samsa is one name, and T.P. Kailasam and Adya Srirangaj. They consciously, but Samsa is not attached company theatre module, but Srirangaji and T.P. Kailasam, they always rethink alternative theatre thing there, because they came from England directly, where they witnessed Shakespeare and even Bernard Shaw like that. If you see Adya Rangaji, one art place, there was 300-600 plays for them. So that is the modern theatre, the realism, what we call realism, Western realism. So Sri Rangaji started, and social drama, it started with Kailasam, T.P. Kailasam. And Samsa, till today, it's very difficult to bring him practical, because he is like a Kannada Shakespeare. The narration, how he writes, the ancient Kannada, it's a medieval Kannada, we say that. That what, when Marathi theatre, Sangli theatre, even Parsi theatre, those times, they were toured Karnataka. Then one Shantakavi, it's our first who started company theatre in Gade, northern part of the Karnataka. There nearly 10-15 companies started. While watching Marathi company theatre, there will be one poetry also he written. That is really amazing thing that what Shantakavi says that ಎಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಲು ಮರಾಠಿಗರ ನಾಟಕ ಕೀರ್ತಿ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಓಪನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಐಸ್ ಎವ್ರಿವೇರ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಮರಾಠಿ ಥಿಯೇಟರ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಮೊದಲು ಮರಾಠಿಯ ನಾಟಕ ಬರ್ತಿ ಎಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿದರೂ ಮರಾಠಿ ನಾಟಕ ಸೊ ಈ ಫೀಲ್ ಹಿಮ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಟು ಇಂಟರ್ಗ್ರಾಟ್ ದೇ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ದೇ ಓನ್ ಅರ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಪೀರಿಯಡ್ ದೇ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇಮಿಟೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಮರಾಠಿ ಕಂಪನಿ ಥಿಯೇಟರ್ ಲೇಟರ್ ಆನ್ They started writing their own plays. So that is, Shantakavi is one of the important names in the northern part, what we call the Karnataka. We divided in north and south, east, west. So like that, in the northern part, many theatre companies, they started. After seeing this, even Mysore Maharaja, Jayachamarajendra Odiyar, in the palace himself, they started company theatre movement. That is called Chamarajendra Karnataka Nataka Sabha. You see that, the title is there. It's the first professional group. Palace itself, the king itself started in palace. Then it's called Sri Tamarajendra Nataka Sabha Mysore, Sakuntala Karnataka Nataka Sabha, Chamaneswari Nataka Sabha, and Rajadhani Nataka Mandali, but it is from Mandya. And Ratnavali Nataka Sabha. Ratnavali is famous for Vardhaka. In the theater, that what even Bidhikarat also always say that, in the company theater, it's a mix of music, dance, and dialogue. But mainly musical oriented. Vardhaka is known for that. He's a very good actor, but while singing, if somebody in the audience says once more, once again, they have to sing like that. Which is there in the Pan-Indian theatre, in the community theatre, possibly you see that. But it came from, once again, colonial rulers through English, through Shakespeare. The what I already so that is started in Calcutta first, then the Mumbai, then later on, from Mumbai, our state influenced with the commercial theatre, what we call party theatre. The theme has been changed in Karnataka, we call it company. We also say that it's Vyavasayi Ranga Theatre, the professional. That is what they, the many people, they started one company. The one of the glorious hera, we call that Gubbi Virena Company. In that Gubbi Company, we saw the two superstars also like that. Our matinee idol, Dr. Rajkumar, is from Gubbi Company, and the theatre giant, B.V. Karant also is from Gubbi Virena Company. So till today, that legend is continuing. B. Jayasree representing the same is a grand daughter of Gubbi Virena. And she also in the industry alumni. But in Karnataka, the repertory means these are all the three major repertory I'm talking about: Neenasam, Rangayana, and Saniyalli Sivasankara. And one more repertory is there, Muruga Rajendra. Other than this, there were many individual theatre directors, playwrights. They do their work like a professional, semi-professional. With the influence of Rangayana, even the Neenasam, many groups, they were quite active in the rural area of Karnataka. That's why, before this, one more thing, I have to say, after emergency, when Prasanna came out from Delhi, he started the Samudaya movement. That Samudaya, the slogan, Prasanna and his colleagues, C.V. Krishnasam, they put it, art is not for art's sake, art is people's sake. That is the slogan Samudaya movement. That is also interest taken from Hipta movement. In pre-independence movement, the Hipta emerged, you know that, happy day, especially in Bombay. There were many, ideologically, they were resisting the imperialist state as well as the colonial rule. Those times, the Hipta movement started. With the influence of that also, in Karnataka, in the regime of emergency, the Samudaya cultural movement emerges. The two cultural data, first time in Karnataka, they taken the burning issue of the day-to-day life, they take an issue to that through the state theater as well as Christian. That's what the first time the theater moved towards the people. That time only in the 80s, that Neenasam Sirila started. At the time, Jambe and K.V. Akshara, K.V. Krishnamurti, they were all alumni. Subanda with this idea, the institute, state institute started. That is, ENT High Institute, Neenasam State Institute. That institute, every year they will take 20 students. At present, we have in Karnataka nearly 600 above graduates from Neenasam itself. Chandra Dasan earlier told that in Karnataka we are very fine. From NS, we have 80 graduates. That is one of the big states. No other state has such a NST graduates. And the institution is the same. But the NST graduates of Karnataka, they never copied what New Delhi taught. You know? They shoot out their own ideologies, their own concept of theatre like that. That is the model taken from NST also, the Neenasam. It created in a Hegel group. It has its own concept of theatre. It means mixing with the ancient Kannada, with the literature, with the music, with the tradition. That's what we always, all the, till today we are facing, the tradition and modernity. It's a conflict. That is, we have to negotiate with these two elements, the tradition and also the modernity. So if you say the Kannada modern theatre, there is a nostalgia in our Kannada theatre, the 70s. When B.V. Karan came out from Delhi, he directed three plays in Ravindra Kalakshetra. So we know that when the Ravindra Kalakshetra emerged in entire India, when celebration happened, Ravindra Tagore, all the capital city, they have the same design of Ravindra Bhavan, Ravindra Sadan, Ravindra Kalakshetra. So it means our Yakshagana and Bailata were all doing the traveling theatres, no? Like that, they were all put it in a box, in a frame, Prussian frame. So it's a Prussian frame also, that modernity decade, that the festival met it as a new eye-opener for the modern Kannada theatre. Earlier, it is an amateur group, they always do in the school colleges for the competition, social drama. But when these three players, Oedipus and the Jokumaraswamy, Sankranti, it's happened and directed by Vivekananda Adi, and one more important carpet, V. Ramoti. He designed all the three plays like this. So that's what all Kannada modern theatre people always go back to the nostalgia that 70s, the beginning of Kannada theatre. But I won't think that before even that, in the small villages, you know, what I told earlier, you know, these areas, through company theatre, they did all the mythological plays. I don't know why, once again, company theatre, they depend on mythology. And company theatre, later on, it shifted to the social drama, but not interested. When cinema emerged, but slowly, company theatre starting imitating film. So all the company theatre artists were all the stalwarts. That's what in Kannada, we have a specific division. Some of the critics, they divide Kannada theatre as that one era is a company theatre era. In the company theatre era, we can see the stars, after stars, what we said. That's what we called Gubbi Veeranna, like that Subbaiya Naidu, Varadachar, like that. To see the actor, the company always owns. That's what I don't know whether it is the division is right or wrong, but this division is there. It is the theatre of actors. The next, one more thing is the theatre of playwrights. So in the playwrights area, where Girish Karnad emerges, Srirangaji. So before that, these three prominent modern dramatists, what I call Samsa, Sriranga, and Kailasa, they inaugurate the modernism in Kannada theatre. And it means we opened our mind to the Western theatre as well as taking from the West. The new translators have been started. The translators started with company theatre itself. Even Romeo and Juliet, we have in Kannada many versions in company theatre. And one more thing, after shoot-out the company theatre, there's another form emerged, that is, the play basically concentrated on historical fact, that Aitihasika Nataka is play, historical play. So it's nearer to the Shakespearean plays, you know. That's what the historical plays, mainly written by Samsa. The Samsa, concentrated on the Mysore king, and he write all the plays and then run that. So like that, if company theater, you made it first, Vyavasaya Rangabhumi, what you get is professional theater. And the audience will pay for that. And there will be a makam they usually put, 3 months, 6 months in the summer season. And also after one area, they will do. In sometimes, you know, the time even Peer Sahib used to do Sajan and Gautam Buddha. So those two were the translation work of Bengali. What? Peer Sahib is a great actor. Even company, you know, everybody, the company, Malika himself became an actor or an organizer like that. Gubbi Veeranna, his place, well, he's a very good organizer as well as the actor. So he brought up all the modernity, the spectacularity of the theater, he brought up. So in that time, the Dasavatara, the floodlights and everything, even moving stage, this kind of excellent they done in the company theater. So when film emerged, the new emerged, these films only started shifting to the film market. Gubbiyuran also shifted to film. Why not like that? So that is the one thing we can't forget, the contribution of after film popularized, that slowly the company theater started imitating the film. Till today, we have companies in Karnataka, in northern Karnataka. They do social dramas and also historical drama. Mainly, two epics, what we know, that the Gubbi company, famous place, that is Kurukshetra. They have Pursamaya, Kitandir, and Rashavata. So, sitting to the, you know, even the company theater also, they taken folk tales, as well as the epics like Ramayana, Mahabharata, Vedran, those only, the play started. And every company have their own dramatists, playwrights working. They have to write. So in modernity, it's not like that. K.V. Subramanya, known as a playwright, as well as is a cultural thinker, is a visionary. So he is sitting in a village, he can visualize, he can interact to the globe. What is going? That was one more thing I have to remember here. When Peter Brook brought his 9 hours play Mahabharata, the only one the mind reacted that K.V. Subramanya, is that Peter Brook on a Maha Ashwamedha Yaga. It is like another East India company, like it's a making like a, it's a when big interactions comes, you know, the supervisor rightly reacted those days. This is once again. We are in this. So we have our own cultural roots. That's why Neena Sam is different than Rangayana. It is different than Anayali Sushantara. And it's never even Neena Sam does company theater also. But there's a formula. Neena Sam last 40 years they done that. This is just thing is they revisited the ancient individual Kannada language also. The Alagannada what he says, ancient Kannada. They produced it. Many people, they said, that nobody understands the Kannada. So that is the strategy Neena Sam wrote last 40 years that one is Alagannada Natka, it means any Kannada, or Sanskrit play, or West. So like that, you have to take everything. So that is the formula. That what, if you say that the syllabus also in Neena Sam, like what we learned in NS, you know, the modern Indian drama, Indian classical drama, Western drama, then the main and stage drama. And there will be a two separate wings for them, specialization, that is direction and design and acting. In my time, there is only two, direction and acting. Now, one more new faculty of the NMR is the design. Now, NST called all the directors called as a designers like that. So this word also came from West. So repertory also like that, but Neena Sam, they didn't put as a repertory. Even Nata Karnataka Rangayana, we called it a repertory company, idea is that. But B.V. Karan's Rangayana, he started 1989, after leaving the Bhupal Rangabandha. You know that, when first time, the contribution of B.V. Karan to such a way in Kannada as well as Indian theatre. The NST means earlier, it is Al-Qazi format of theatre. Ibrahim Al-Qazi, who in Nehruvian era, he created the National Institute, that is based on exploring all the Indian culture as well as the Western mode. So that time only the industry repertoire emerged. But when B.V. Karan joined as a director, he decentralized, he opened all the roads. So in that B.V. Karan vision, from students from Meghalaya, Assam, Manipur, even Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka started coming. Even without knowing Hindi and English, they interacted with the Indian theatre. So I am not saying that Al-Qazi and Karan also is a student of Al-Qazi only. But his reason is different. Because his background is from Gubbi company, Rupi company. He worked in as a sand artist. Later on, B.V. Karanji done his MA in Banaras Vishwavidyalaya and learned music in Hindustani music. And finally, he got that part when he became a director. He opened, he decentralized the industry in the clear manner. So at the time, many of our NFT, Kannada people, they joined in it. The current regime only, it's open to the all. So earlier it was not like that. That's why NFT also have a discussion. It's only Hindi-based. Hindi-based is place where it's happening, and the Southern, even non-Hindi speaking students, they never get the role. So in that fight only, that's how we got the NFT Bangalore. Earlier it was the RRC, then it was the flex school. Till today, I'm telling you, next year, NSC also going to start the repetition comes for Bangalore Center. The, once again, government funded. And one more thing, without government support, public support, we can't do repetition company. So that is the our right, cultural rights, we say that. That's the civilized government should support art and culture, literature. So we are not begging anybody. In the company sector era, what the people, they were feeding them, you know, with the ticket and everything. There is no government, especially that Mysore Prince State supported one company. The later people themselves, they supported the company. But in modern times, at any cost, you have to defend public or public money. The government means any form of government. That is a basic right. We have a right to ask. That was in German Bensal and Sula started with Brecht, with the support of government only. So that's why there is also there, if totally government, the problem emerges. That's what our present Rangayana is facing. Because that bureaucracy emerges, they will dictate the culture. You have to do this, this like that. But up to my period, you know, that's what B.V. Karan's in between, he resigned the Rangayana company. When he started, 89. But the first repertory company, modern theatre company, we call it as Sirigatta only. It started once again moving towards the people. Every year, earlier they have a three plays. It's one from Kannada, one from Sanskrit, and one from West. And the syllabus also, the it is not same like industry. That's what they created the theatre concept they started. Basic issue of the theatre concept. They were not saying modern Indian drama and classical. That is there, but concept of theatre is the main thing. The second one, history of the drama. Drama is related from Greek to contemporary modern Indian drama as well as the Kannada drama. And also the history of the theatre. So it's a different syllabus. It looks like an NST syllabus, but it's a different. It's a based on our own culture like that. And one is acting. The acting also, not just blindly following the industry. They have their own Yakshagana, Talamaddala concept for the scene. Yoga is there. And also they mix with all the martial arts also, the collage. What is available in the region? Whereas in Rangayana, if you come, Karan started, what is available in Mysore? So B.V. Karan, when he started Rangayana company, his main dream is to start 5 Rangayana. Why 5 Rangayanas? In Karnataka, we have 30 districts. At least 5-6 districts unified, you have to start 8 Rangayana company. Because if the northern part, if it is a Hyderabad, Karnataka, the Hyderabad, Karnataka have a different culture. That's why earlier I said with you, then the Kalyana Karnataka name is renamed. Now you won't call the Karnataka, Kalyana Karnataka, it's a new name, as earlier it is Hyderabad, Karnataka. So it's included with the Nizam region, free independence. Now, the Karnataka renamed that Hyderabad Karnataka as a Kalyana Karnataka, where in 12th century, the Basava, Allama Prabhu, Akkama Devi, these kind of five poets. And also, they have a artisan class, that the philosophy is that Kayakave Kailas. The work is worth it. They believe that. So, such a way, that part, B.V. Karan that not only just Panganappa Mysore, we have to concentrate northern part as well as the Karavali and also the Bailusine, what is that plainland, the Mysore. So now at present, after Vivekananda, the refugee, Sabin Sutong, is at present we have four Gainas. One is from the Malnadu region, is the Shivamogga, and the Dharwada, another Gaina, and Kalburgi, that is Hyderabad Karnataka, that is Kalyana Karnataka. And one more repertory, the government planning to start in the Bengaluru. So this Bengaluru will correct at least 5 districts like that. So that is the division, but I don't know whether Karanji fully successful in Bhopal Rangmandal. We know that Bhopal Rangmandal is the Ashok Vajpayee is a banker of that, the Madhya Pradesh government, which we created entire ambience of Bhopal Rangmandal. The painting gallery is there, even the folk art. And there, in that experiment, Vivekananda's ability to that, he taken tribal artists as well as foreign artists. The language also, Bundelkhandi, Chhattisgarh language, as well as the Audi language, English. So here also, Karan's dream is like that. The Kannada is not just one Kannada. It's the Dharwada Kannada is there, Mysore Kannada is there, Mangalore Kannada is there. At least, and also the writer, the playwright. We have to concentrate on those regional repetitions like that. That's why government of Karnataka is convened. Later on, they started all Koyirangana. But the one thing, like Neerasam Yeggoru, is a different mode of repertory company. It stagnated in Mysore. The Karan always says that when I'm a repertory chief and Vivekananda is heading that company, after him only I taken over as a director. I worked with Rangayana 10 years, 5 years as a repertory chief with Baba Karan, and 5 years as a independent repertory company. In my time, I started DSS like you were saying, it took 2 years. So, we have one more concept of Rangayana, it's a Makam concept. That is, the Makam is also not new thing. That's what the company theater used to do. When they rehearse the play, they tour the entire state, and even the entire nation sometimes. The big company, when they tour to travel to the train also, for the carrying lines, set, exaggerated, settlements like that, properties like that. So, Karan's in the beginning, when he started Nataka Karnataka Rangayana, the full day, always Karan simply the later way he used to say, in Karnataka there is a Nataka. He always said that. Nataka Karnataka. Oh, Karnataka always karta hota hai Nataka. Is tarah meaning mein wo mazak bhi karta hai, lekin it is there. So, that is his. Rangayana is a dream child of Baba Karan. I couldn't get his listen. When I joined the industry, Baba Karan shifted to Bhopal Rangmandal. So I have worried, I worked with Prasannaji, with Samudaya Chetu Group at the beginning. So later on, I did Samudaya also as a state president. So after passing out from NSC graduation, I started touring my own state from Bidar to Chamarajanagara. So that was Neerasam Sirata, last 40 years, that is the same thing. It is not just limited to the Yeggoru village. After 3 plays, the entire year they tour, at least 6 months. Earlier there is a 3 plays, now they confined to the 2 plays. So Maru Tirugata, they say that. So consciously, they select the play. If it is a serious play, the always Subhanaji and Aksharas believe that. So, we should not confine to the audience viewpoint. We have to do our work. If it is a serious, no problem. At least we have to sensitize the people. We have to educate. So, Neerasam firmly believe that theater didn't bring the revolution. Everybody believes that. It is good, but it will create an impact. That's what Neerasam Sirigata last 40 years created the impact on young minds, especially the young generation. Everywhere, usually they will take theater as a professionalism. So Rangayana is in Mysore is different because in my resume, the first time in the world, the repertory company artists have been permanent. Now one by one they were retiring. So the, because of that, when Vivekananda taken students, this is an interesting thing. Babakaran taken 6 months to select the repertory artists for Nalanda. The nook and corner of the Karnataka, the day audition they took place, the day first they invited 300 applicants. Later on, they made it half of that, 150. Later on, the 70, out of 70, finally they selected 25. So it means the Rangayana Mysore repertory, the pan Karnataka, what is called, be there to Chamarajanagara, the representation is there. So that is the idea. Later on, these trained artists, they will go to their hometown, they will create the theatre activities. That is Babakaran dream, but the dream couldn't happen because when in the midway, when Vivekananda left Rangayana in 1994 with the conflict with the government, because I am there with the country, Vivekananda simply asked, we need a bus and a lorry to carry our properties. We are starting 22. Those time, Karanjyas is just 30 lakhs. But government is astonished. Whoa, my goodness. For a place, it's 30 lakhs. But we know in Karnataka, for every cultural event, the government spending close together money. But when the government bureaucracy didn't convince Babakaran, just Rangayana. So at that time, I am there in Sriram Center Repertory Company, directing a play for them. So finally, they called me back. So what Babakaran dreams, I'm listening with him, you know, as a repetitive to the artist also. As a faculty, I worked as a teacher, as well as the repetitive director. With the Babakaran, so the Rangayana toured entire Europe like that. With the Hippolytus, first time in Appa Broadway, Lamama Company. We put 30 shows in Kannada, in the Lamama Company. It's a cultural exchange like that. So Mysore Rangayana sometimes toured with Midsummerization to the entire Europe. So later on in Mayarism, he started to do the makam in the
broadcast.
So
train logo martine nan jothe kootha alli emu hoga ella broadcast maadi kudu number sir
hello
sudupige nodbeku nodthe
so like another one more repetitive among with the instance of Neena Samthirata, that is Sane Elisu Satyara. It's actually Sri Pandithraj Swamiji is a there is a Veerashaiva Mata. The main Swamiji, that Taranavan Swamiji, he himself is a playwright. So propagates Vachana movement and also the Swasarana philosophy, they started theatre as a weapon, the drama, to propagate the issues of the Veerashaivism as well as the religious
preaching.
The one thing is that Swamiji Chandradasan, hello.
Yes.
No, there is a disturbance in between. Somebody is talking, I don't know.
Yeah, I have muted down, sir.
Huh?
Muted down. You can continue.
Okay. So, Susanchara, the one thing, at a time, they can accommodate 5,000 audience. One big amphitheater is there, the Greek model, it is there. Because every November, they organize a national festival, sometime they do international festival also. The main theme of Susanchara is that always to propagate the Vachanakara philosophy. That's why every time they have one play on Sharana, whether it's a Baswanna or Allama Prabhu, there was 350, 60 Sharana per day. So one, and also with the Prayoga Ranga Prayoga Sane, Sri Sukuna Prayoga Ranga Sane, when C.R. Jambe is the principal is there, they introduced once again the formula of doing one Western drama and as well as one the Sarana drama and modern Kannada drama like that. So this kind of module is there, and Swamiji also visited the and influenced with the Veerasam Kiryattam. But Rangayana is a full-fledged supported by government of Karnataka, Department of Karnataka. This is part and parcel of the government. But earlier in Vivekananda, in my reason, there is a freedom. Then the artistic freedom is there. Now it is not there. That's the problem. So for every government institution, you know, then became. Meenasam somehow was fully autonomous because the government used fund, but they can't dictate it. That's why Meenasam spread out. Their students also, they need not to worry. They can imagine, they can think their own expression of the theater. So, like last 20 years, Sushilchar also traveling. I did nearly last 10 years, I directed play for them. At a time, they will see 5,000 audience. Once when Open Air Theatre Lima reopened, I put Tuam Pushpan play, Berelige Kori. So, at a time, there were 20,000 audience came to that to see that inaugural function and also the theatre. It's like a Greek module. So that the same night I have to repeat the show that Berani Puran. If the one day it's happened two shows, it means 10,000 people they witnessed. Then later on they put it LED also to public like that. So this kind of cries in the villages, you know, till today in Karnataka, we have support for the repetitive company. That's why Meenasam last 40 years is traveled look and color of the state. They have a program, the planned program. Even the play, and not only just not Meenasam lecturers are Akshara, Jambaya, Kasumudri. They were inviting all over the Indian, Tamil, and also the international. That kind of interaction, it's open to the globe. So Rangayana also in the earlier time, that's what Vivekananda did. So many European writers, they came to that place. One from German, he did Magadavuri, like that. Even Hippolytus is from Greece. Even Midsummer Night's Dream directed by a German director like that. So this kind of Kannada theatre always is open-minded. When Rangayana started, Vivekananda easily says like a sutra like that. The modern Kannada theatre, we have to always remember the expectation of the amateur theatre. And visual vaibhava of Ruthi company, that is complicated. So with the combination of these two, you have to do excellence on the repertory. That is the main theme always Vivekananda used to say that. So that what he couldn't succeed in the Bhopal Rangamandali, he somehow he succeeded in the Rangayana, but later on, currently in the end of the era, Saro, he left the Rangayana. So that is the one story. But Rangayana is never stopped. But that time only, now Rangayana once again rethinking everything. Now the political influence is there. The thought everybody was worried about. But the cultural freedom and autonomous institution it didn't get. It's very problem. But Sushilchara is not there. That is also taking government money. But the Sushilchara have their own amateur group once again. Once again, they started drama school, 1 year diploma course. Meenasam also started theatre school. Rangayana also started theatre school, the Bharatiya Rangashikshana Kendra. So these three fields are different, but Meenasam after SSLC, they can easily go up to degree. But whereas in Sushilchara, they will take SSLC as well as PU. In Rangayana, PU. But NST, we are offering only graduates only. That's why the NST only constituting on graduates, whereas Meenasam, Rangayana, they will take from 10th onwards. That is the interesting thing. Even the rural Dargon students also, if they have interest in theater, they can easily, that everybody can't go NST in order. So always we say that if somebody asks me, I am an alumni of NST. If they want to go NST, I first go to the Meenasam. The part you can learn in our mother tongue. The part what NST has in Delhi, they have a wonderful syllabus in Meenasam also. That's what in Ragana also they were doing the same thing. So one thing before, I forgot to tell that, the process of selecting the repertoire artist. So Vivekanand, first time, tried after 5 years. 5 years now. That's what all the Kannada people, they started murmuring. How many days the training is going to help? How many days Vivekanand is going to take the trained artist? So because everybody wants, you know, there is a one model is there always, you know, from Tirata. They were traveling. But Rangana is not moving towards the villages or another area. That's what is one current deep in the reason there is a poor Varanga. Before doing the major play and touring the company, you will see the location. That is current deep is poor Varanga. But the response, actually, the time itself, they started comparing with NSA repertory, Nirasam repertory. Karan became Nava, Baba Karan. We say that it's a poor Varanga, not full-fledged production. So that what Baba Karan, you know, if once he take back, he can't. It's a little bit further. So that what Atpakata Hindiralare, Andiki Vogalare, always to say that. But it's a wonderful visionary, but if you get intellectual freedom as well as the expression freedom, Karan never say that. That was the Rangayana. Now we are all feeling that we are suffering. In the NSC also the same thing is there without any decision from the higher level. So the state companies also have high command, like political parties. This is the saddest thing in our part. So anyhow, I am very happy that Kannada stated all the interests. There was much impact on these repertory companies. Every small group, they want to start repertory companies. One more information I have to share with you people. The Karnataka, every year, at least from central government, they are getting 10 crore in the name of repertory. But I know just 5-6 repertory companies, if I name them, not more than, but the fund is there, lot of fund is there. But our government also is open enough to give money for the amateurs group, even repertory company, theatre festival. But our simple government of Karnataka culture budget itself is a 600 crore. So 300 to 600. There's no government in India, any government, has such a huge amount. And because we have interacting with the government, and for the good purpose, they will provide. Then we say that that's our right. That's our right to build the Kannada culture as well as the culture language. Now, and one more repertory, Jamura, it is there. There is also a religious institution. They were also propagating Hindu philosophy. They have a seasonal repertory, semi-seasonal repertory. They will also take artists who are all from pastors from Nina, Sama, Rangana, like that. So Rangana also have present to 4 repertory companies. Our students also, unless the pastoral students also, they will get there also. Because and one more, after passing out Nina, some many graduates, they started their own repertory. That's a very interesting thing happened in Karnataka. One is from Kodagu, Susti Kodagu Ranga. Now he is getting Mysore Rangana as a director at the Nakaya. And one more, Iqbal Amar, he is not NSC alumni, but he is a Nirasam graduate. But he created his own children's repertory called Chinna Banna. He also traveled with the children's play. The elders doing the children's play. That is also a new concept emerged with Chinna Banna. And later on, K.J. Krishnamurthy is also NSC alumni as well as the Nirasam graduate. He started Kinnara Veda, the children's theatre company. It's running last 25 years, Kinnara Veda. And two more repertories from Nirasam also graduates they started. One is Atamata, Janamana Data. That is the impact Nirasam did in Kannada theatre. Earlier, Samudaya made it in different ideologically with the street theatre. But Nirasam, the professionalism, all the answers, they took theatre as a professionalism. So that was, now you are looking at the professionalism and commitment to the theatre. So without commitment and professionalism, we can't create. To be, doing film is an easy thing, but creating a play, organizing a company is not easy. But in Karnataka, somehow, the people encourage the support we are getting from the nookad corner of the Karnataka, the people thing, and some of them, even Neenasam, they have their own sponsoring body. All over Karnataka, Neenasam have the sponsorship body. So, Kirgata, like that, even Sivasankara also have their own sponsoring body. But whereas Rangayana, that kind of tour, it has to, it to start, not starting. That's what there is a criticism regarding Rangayana, is more sour Rangayana, it's a static. So, that's why Karan always used to say, no, 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 the repertory company, if they get bored in their town, they have to tour, to learn. So, that is also their, but everybody just going touring, touring, it is also no meaning. Yeah, but Rangayana impact is there that if they produce one production, yeah, I directed 3-4 fronts for them. Till today, they have my production. Gandhi vs. Gandhi, Sudarsa Patni, even Kusuma Bale. And Raghunandan, one of the best production of Gunamukha. Still, it is there with them. So, Karan Daira has to, the permanency, the repertory company, at least in 20, 30 years also, the player should be is there with the repertory company as a stock. Wow. So, the moving every time place to place is also sometimes it's good. It's a program. But the repertory company in the modern time, we can't move like the company theater concept. But the company also, when they travel from place, they put 3 months, 5 months in the area. So that is the idea always Baba Karan used to say for our Rangayana, it is a you have to implement the world concept of company theater. You have to do the makam, putting 5-6 persons in a place, 30 days, 40 days. Later on, you have to come back to the destiny, where we start from, like that. So Rangayana, now they have one more touring company, that is Junior Rangayana. Last 2-3 years, they started touring now. So that is also with a big mega production one called Kulampus, Ramayana Darshanam. With the ancient Kannada, they did the production. Rangayana also, till today, they didn't exercise samsara play because so retarded, it was very complicated place, samsara. Sriranga plays Vivikar, himself he did Kattale Belaku, and Sriranga Ramana we did it. Even Devanur Madhava novel also we adapted. Shakespeare is there. So Prasanna, the became a Prasanna as a director. He once again reopened Rangayana with Bauruti, like Barangam, you know, the national, international festival we started. Everybody have their own program. Neenasam, he has their Samskruti Shibara and the 7 days in October theatre festival. And also extension program then there. Rangayana also, they have Bauruti, who is a national, every year there will be a national festival. And also one more program in my district we started, then Sinara Vela. Later on, when Jambeji is there, that time, the Sweden government supported the children's theater. UNESCO also supported. That is, till today, Sinara Mela is active in Sinara Mela. Because the Sinara Mela kids, they bring their parents to the Rangayana. That's why in Rangayana, if one production happens, nearly 80-100 shows the production should happen. I know the Girish Karnad Taladanda, in my time itself, is completed 80 shows. My own play, that is Sudarsa Patni, are 150 shows. So, Neenasam, touring entire Karnataka, they do 150-200 shows. Whereas Rangayana, placing in the place are Mysore and everything, they're doing at least 30-40 shows in there. But that company should tour. Otherwise, we can't negotiate with the different districts. That is there. That's what Rangayana facing the problem. It can't move. So now, that's why they started the 3-4 Rangayana. That Rangayana also, within there, they were imitating Mysore Rangayana. So what Baba Karan said has, even mine and Prasanna, so that have been, till today, it's making. They should implement. We have to develop dramaturgs there from that reason. Artists, as well as the director, and it has to be interchangeable. It should travel. So that is the idea. And Neena Samkrigata and Susan Chara, they were doing wonderful. And one more thing, Susan Chara, they toured entire India one time. Bharataranga Sanchara, they did it. The Department of Culture as well as the Academy sponsored them. They given funds. With the bus, they toured entire North India, as well as Northeast also. They done 80 shows with three plays in India. So one more time they did it, Sivadesa Sanchara. It means taking bus of philosophy to the people. So Neena Assam, they have clear concept of theater. That institution never closes their eyes. It's open to all. And they have their own concept of culture through the Subanna, great visionary. That same legacy carried out by K.B. Akshar also. One more thing, everybody have good libraries also. In the Neena Assam also, at present, even Vivekanand, all the 15,000 books is started by Baba Kodi Venkatramana Trust. The Neena Assam reason for the research, so they started research center, all the musical instruments, books available in Ragayana. And Neena Assam, now after 40 years, they were uploaded in all productions in YouTube also. With Santi Foundation. It means, the Kannada means, we are not saying, Rangayana is there in a different manner. The Susanchara is there in another manner. Murugaraja, they have their own ideologies. But amateurs also, now interacting with the respective company. So that was always facing NST, Rangayana like that. Everybody have right to ask government institutions. There are, if it is a autonomous private, nobody asks. So that is there, that there is a lot of criticism on Rangayana, even for NST. But why everybody want to participate in Bharangam? Bharangam is not meant for only NST graduates, no? It's the entire world. So that is there, the criticism always there. In my matter, many people in Karnataka, they scold me, they criticize me, Basu is a white elephant. They say that. I am putting mega products, you know. Yeah, my idea. Why should I waste my energy for just 300-500 people? At least 1,000 people, because we know theater, you can't make a cricket stadium, you can't put our production. So I tried one production like that also, Mansur Jati Tanajan, Michael Stone program. So the budget itself 5 crores, but my artist is 500 artists. At least they got 30,000 rupees for a month. So it means you have to do that to the artist. The repertory company means, it means you have to feed our artists, where film they were getting a lot of money, serial they were getting. What about the theater artists? So that was, I firmly believe that, Baba Karan also believe that, the artist should get good money and try name. So that was the smaller, there will be a Vaisa Varsa, picture is there, it is there, without criticism, theater never clarified, I believe firmly. So this is the Kannada. It means from company to Girish Karna to till today, we have more playwrights. So it means in the Western concept of repertory companies, they're entirely different. If you say Bansal and Samla, the Brett is director as well as a playwright. He created his own repertory. Whereas in Stanislavski methodology, that Moscow Theatre, so that was Chekhov is there, Stanislavski is there. The same method our company is done. But how can you believe just this institution only repertory? What about Kavalam Narayan Pandikar? It's Kavalam Narayan Pandikar. Sopalam is for me, it's a repertory company itself. I don't know whether the artists were paid or not. So the amateur group, even Abhijit Tanvi, he created his own repertory for the tribal region, Chhattisgarh. So that's the difference. He's not able to graduate. Even Kanaya Lalji. Forget Arthanti Amdi, he's an NST alumni, and he do his production, he always participates, he represents India through Manipuri language only, Arthanti Amdi. If you compare with Manipuri theatre, Aranda work and Kanayalala work, Savitri work is a different work. The same language is different. So new generation are emerging there. So that's what I'm happy next month, next week, Ravichita Guga is going to stay. What she done, I know her theater. So like that in India, the introduction to the this tradition as well as the modernity is the main core of conflict. We have to go through that. We have to face. So it may be, I firmly believe, doing theater itself is a politics. It is a cultural politics we do through theater. We are not doing any sloganeering for the any party or, but doing theater itself, it will bring slow changes. That's what Nina from probably believes that. They never give slogans, but slowly through the literature, through the ancient literature, Sanskrit theater, with the tradition, they were interacting with that. They were negotiating with that. That's what Subhanavi, the main philosophy, some extent, Nina from succeeded, and it made its impact on Kannada theater. So that's why, I also worked once, I directed one play there. But that impact, Rangayana is not the same. This is purely Sarkara. Sarkara bureaucracy is there with that. If the minister changes, even the directors also change. So last year, that's what happened. The government changed. All the Rangayana have been turned off. Even members also. So that's what government created a cultural policy with Naroda Bhargu Ramchandra. I am also one of the members. We told that, why is government interfering in the artist? Why is people interfering in the poet? They can't say, no, you have to write poetry like this. They can't dictate the playwright to write like this poet. That is there. There's a propaganda state also there. For them, they have an information center for that to propagate government program. So now, entire electronic media, that's what they are doing, all the television, it's a paid channels they're propagating. But whereas, the theater is not a duality. That is individual as well as is a community. So that's what Rangayana, even Neenasam believe that. Neenasam, Subarna, he never say that I am the only winner of the Neenasam. That is the community, a go to community, the society created that. So finally, that small village, they expanded in the higher level with the Karnataka theater. And later on, it lifted to global world. That's why you go to honored with the Magsaysay Award. We know that. But whereas Vivekananda didn't take, because Vivekananda, he never stopped in a single place. Delhi, he stayed just 3-4 years, he lifted to Bhupal Rangmandal. There also he couldn't complete with the controversy. He moved to Mysore. Mysore also he didn't complete his message, you know. So like that. That is the problem with Baba Karan. But as a visionary, but I have a wonder admiration in Baba Karan. He really started what is Indian theater, what is artistry. That's why NST is flourishing. It's a decentralizing everywhere. We are fighting with our institution. Yeah, as an NST graduate, I always quarrel with NST, with its ideas and its country. So like that is, it's a democratic country. We have a different, you have to interact with the people only. Finally, the theater is such a beautiful art. Even playwright, director, never said it. Finally, the actors and the audience, they were the communication. So that was in Kannada, every major theater, director, playwright, even the artists, we believe that theater is not meant for only playwright or director. It is the business between, this is the dialogue between actors and the audience. So that's why in Kannada, repetitive companies is doing the new dialogue. If it is a, and doing mystic also, it's a new learning process, you know. That's what Neenasam also slowly emerged. It organizes a Sanskriti Shibira. There were 170, 200 people participating. They were going to know the ancient literature, what is happening. So it means, Subarna once in an interview rightly said that we don't need history of theater. We need a the tradition memory that we call Smriti. The Smriti we need. We need not interact for every issue, the contemporary issue. Whether in Mahabharata can we get the solution for this contemporary issue, day-to-day life. That is the philosophy Neenasam believes. Whereas Rangayana also said thing. Doing all these things, we know that one word I have to Here I read it out in the T.S. Eliot easily says that. We always state, we believe, you know, it is for Trikal, okay, time, space, and action. That is the one theory. And all the Westerners, the theory is the theater. The latest theory will be got from Richard Sackler, there is the environmental theater. What he called the Therukuttu, it is not an environmental theater in our tradition in Tamil Nadu. The Yakshagana Bhailata is not an environmental theater, whereas Bhutaradhane or Sayam is not an environmental theater. So, the Westerners, they were very popular theorizing the things. But our Pandi, the visionaries, they never do that. Because we firmly believe that theater is an aradhana, it's a ritual. That what Yakshagana still the companies were alive, because there is a faith, the religious belief is there. But in modern theater, we have to rebuild the modern belief. The faith you have to build it, at least for the professional itself, at least the idea. So not just using theater for a propagating idea. It is there, there is a popular theater is there, many. But the mainly theater is from tradition. It has many, many concepts. And also, you have to speak with the metaphor. We can't do directly, we can't announce many things, you know. So these are all the things. One thing I have to read and conclude my session. So one here's in it, I taken from Nakshara Bhutani. Time present and time fast, I repeat, time present and time fast are both perhaps present in time future, are both perhaps present in time future, and time future is contained in time fast. You see, the theory is a trikala jnana, it means we have to go back to the past we have to bring to the present. The present, we can't do as it is as a present. We have to make it fast. We have to link with the Smriti. And even the future has to be a dusty present. I don't know, after 20, 30 years, Vedamaya, but the tradition is going to be there. The Smriti is there. The history, who written? We all know the colonial history. That what the politics, deliberation is going on. Huh? The history of India is not our history. That what political parties are saying. What is history? History means. So, in cultural history, there is no such history. I also believe we have a memory, the tradition. The tradition, even Ramayana, Mahabharata, Bhagavata, it may come not as it is as a vachya. It means it can be a metaphor. It has given a solution from the past. So, to build a future society, in the present we can't make just. That's why in India we couldn't develop realistic art, naturalistic art, in what rest they believe. We couldn't create Ibsen or Chekhov. So, that is the Indian concept of theater, I believe. Mine also, we for exercise, we do realistic everything. It is their form. I believe firmly in my expression, always I believe magical realism. My stories is like that. In Kusumabale, the road itself is a character, it's speaking. That's why I did Volesvenka's road. What is that Volesvenka road in Sagwa? He reacting colonial rules as an African writer, Nigerian writer. The road itself is a central focal character in that. So in modern time, the part in what we call about development. What is the development? What's the development? So we thought, develop ourselves, internal journey with the art, culture, literature. Even now we are talking about the country was the one nation, one religion, one language. What does it mean? So theater is a plural. Pluralism is a samasthi here. Not individual. The India also not just individual. That's what in the beginning I quoted. ಭಾರತ ಜನನೀಯ ತನುಜ ಆಸೆ ಜಯೇ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಮಾತೆ ಮೆನಿ ನೇಷನ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಯುನಿಫೈಡ್ ಬಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅವರ್ ಓನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಕನ್ನಡ ಆಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಓನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ನಾಟ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಕನ್ನಡ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಸವರ್ನ್ ಕನ್ನಡ ಲೈಕ್ ಮಲಯಾಳಂ ಆಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಮಲಯಾಳಂ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಮೆನಿ ಮಲಯಾಳಂ ತೆಲುಗು ತಮಿಳು ಈವನ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕಂಪೇರ್ ವಿತ್ ಮೈ ಕನ್ನಡ ಎಸ್ಎಸ್ಸಿ ಅಂಡ್ ತಮಿಳು ವೆನ್ ಅವರ್ ಪಂಪ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಎಪಿಕ್ ಆನ್ ಮಹಾಭಾರತ ದ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಲಿಟ್ರೇಚರ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎಟ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಟು ದ ಎನ್ಸಿಕ್ಲೋಪೀಡಿಯಾ ಆಫ್ ದ ತಮಿಳ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟೂ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಎನ್ಸಿಕ್ ಸೊ ಈವನ್ ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ದೇ ಡಿಡ್ಂಟ್ ಓಪನ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಮಾಡರ್ನ್ ಮಾಡರ್ನಿಸಮ್ ದೋಸ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಒಂದು ಸೆಮಿನಾರ್ ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಸೆಮಿನಾರ್ when NSP started, even Sangeetharth Academy, many academies started, our many cultural activist experts, they asked the government in Nehru Nagar, so we need more support. We need a ministry on that. That time, our great lady, that is Kamala Chattopadhyay says that, oh my God, If you take a cultural ministry, the art will die. The artist will die. You say that. The part, our voice is all those things. 50 years back, in a seminar, he told us, don't demand a ministry giri for that, for a cultural minister. That's what you are facing in Karnataka. The politicians, they talk about, because they provoke people in the name of language, in the name of the boundary, the name of the water, river, name of the culture, name of the religion. So artists should very, very clearly, we belong to this nation. Not only now in globalization, I belong to England also, Africa also. That universality should have. That impact, repetitively, in our state. Neena Sam created that. Even Rangana also firmly believed that. Many people, that was even Sanayandi also believed that. The Baswana not belong just to Karnataka. He belongs to everybody. But he's not translated to English. That is there now. Vachana is not available in, except A.K. Ramanujam translation of Vishnu of Shiva. Nobody knows. Even our Kuwepo, nobody knows. Other states, we know Tagore. With whom you know Tagore? When 100 years celebration happened, the government itself started a grand design of one theater. Everywhere, the same design, Ravindra Kala Theater. So if I do my play in Bengaluru, I didn't get Ravindra collections for the last 30 years. You won't get. That's why I stood out, I tried my productions, I not depending on your kalakshetra or your kalagrama. I have my own space. But this traction where I got, it's my tradition only. It's my Yakshagana Bhairata, it's my Bhutaradhane, it's my Krishna Parijata. So these are all the things we have to go back and we have to bring to the present time and we can't give solution through the play. We don't have answer. With the play, we can't dissolve a political leader. We can give a suggestion. We have an interaction with that issue. So that's why theater is a metaphor. It's a poetry. That's why we call it visual poetry. Theater is a visual poetry. It's the symbols with the metaphor, with the simile, we are expressing our emotions. That's what the Kannada repertory company, not 100% on time, some of them, especially Neenasam, is doing the wonderful work. Rangayana, because of this political intervention and the changing of the new directors, they have their own idea. But there is even we can't follow the rules. I can't say, Chandradasan, you have to direct like this one. When you did your Kariyadevara Udike, I have seen that. That production 30 years back. But when I see here in our Suraya Theater, it's astonishing. For me, it's a new thing. Oh my goodness. Well, it's a feminist play. For me, it's like a feminist play. The women first time they were questioning that. And if you directly connect with what is going on contemporary India, what is happening in Ayyappa Swami Temple, indirectly we can relate that. So that is the beauty of the theater. The beauty of the cutting, or painter, or the poetry, or the piece. So I firmly believe that we should be not individualist, we should be pluralist, and we should be a mega party. So that's what I believe Kannada repertory companies, even the new genre, the new playwrights are emerging. They were once again, we are simply said that go back to the room. Don't bring as it is. Integrate with the contemporary world. And we are doing for live people. They know what is Ramayana, Mahabharata. They know everything. They know Bhagavata. So if you bring even Shakespeare, you have to do our own. That's why Baba Karanti did Barnamana. The Macbeth came with a Yakshagana step, not westernized casting, you know. So when Panikkar Bahubati's place, that Basa, it is in the Kerala flavor is there. That is like total Indian theatre, I believe. That's what the industry also never dictates you. It's gradient. It always says that, yeah, you have to see the classical Indian drama, and as well as what doing West, what is our folk theatre doing, is the appropriate to that. The theatre artist always the student of theatre only. Till today, I'm learning many things as a student with my students. So it's a never-ending thing. And what the play Aristotle says, there is a concept, middle, beginning, middle, end. But I won't believe that. I never said, that's what my main workplace says that, the preamble, prologue is that, illi yaro mukkiyaralla, yaro mukkiyaralla. No one important, no one unimportant. The space is also, it's not a pure. If it is a pure, the opposite word is unpure. That's what India are facing, you know, pure and unpure. Who is pure? Yeah, that's what we are facing now in our state, the new ordinance state, Go Puja. Go is a holy cow. If holy cow is there, what about the blessing? So the politics start. So it means that dividing the people in the name of culture, the creator, the creative artist, they never target. They will react with their expression. The painter will react his own way, the poet will react his own way, the theatre artist will react their own way. So that is the bit of theatre. That's why theatre is a composite and complicated, complex, but it is a plural. That's what Baba Karanth dreamt it when Rangayana started. He organized the entire Karnataka from Bidar to Chamarajanagara. When Subbanna started his amateur group, keeping in his own village, he spread out he centralized the entire village as a global village. That is the role model at Karnataka. And all the parallel movements of today, that's the cultural movement. Samudaya is created in 70s, 80s. We know that. An amateur group also still active in Karnataka. The amateurs, they turned as a repertory artist slowly. They want to study a serious state student with the NSC or Meenasam or Rangayana or Kaneyalli, because every repertory they have their own state school. One more information later. 2 months back only, one more Rangayana started for company theater, government of Karnataka started. In Davanagere Jilla, it's a odd place of the company theater. It's a commercial place, Davanagere. That is, there will be a 5-4 acres land is there. Our one more theater director, Sardesh Pandey, he appointed as a director there. But they have to start training on company theater, Parsi theater. Parsi theater didn't have any school. The earlier Gubbi company have their own school. They have to learn music, they have to learn speech and movement. Every professional company, they have their own school. In modern terms, the theatre affects their own school, like Srinivasam, NSC. That is the role model now. NSC repertory, when we started, when Alkaji started, after passing out graduation, they joined there. No? Yeah, I know. I have a really wonder. Last 70 years, industry produced so many graduates. I'm worried about Hindi belt. No Hindi graduate went back to his hometown. He simply shifted to Mumbai. Even I have to ask next, Ashish Siddharthi also. He shifted to Bombay only. Now he's considered in South India. What about his state? So this is the questions. We have our own questions, queries, but we can't dictate everybody, you know, what I'm doing is the right thing. So this is the thing, I'm happy. So the bullet points I said with you people, if the questions comes, you know, I can elaborate my discussion. The focus on these 3-4 companies, you know, I delivered my lecture. Baba Karan, individually is a Baba Karan, but is a Mana community. K.V. Subbanna, yeah, he looked like an individual, but when he got the Maxis Award, he didn't serve an individual. He said that this entire Maxis belongs to the Golden Village and also Karnataka. That's plurality. That is the understanding of Kannada, our intellectuals, the cultural thinker, and that thinking level, they were transformed to the young generation. So what I learned from Baba Karan, Prasannaji, CDK, and K.V. Subbanna, what I learned with my elders, I'm sharing with my students also. So that's what you have to make a good cultural discourse. That's what we can rebuild the real Indian theatre. For Indian theatre, so I have an objection. What is Bharatiya Rangabhoomi? What I'm doing is an Indian theatre itself. So we can't negotiate. So Bharatiya Rangabhoomi means just belongs to the Hindi language or Sanskrit language. So my language as equivalent to the Sanskrit. Yeah, Sanskrit we know it's an ancient language. Kannada, Tamil also is an ancient language for me. Without knowing Tamil, I can't interact with my medieval Kannada. Without knowing Kashmir Sadism, I can't interact with my Virsaiva and Basava philosophy. So like that, the theater evolves entire globe. The last word, I really always say that what takes place this, you know, entire globe is a Rangamani. We're all traveling in the there and after. So you are playing in a time, in the past tense, you are bringing the present with a different costume. The present, we are mythifying the thing, it is a different costume. So in every time, the present, past, future, you have to hear the different costumes, different genre, and different properties. That how you have to hear, because Indian theatre is not a real history or natural history. It is this way. That's why Girish Karnad, one play is done in realistic way, Kanjubal Lige, it's not popular. Like Togelak or Nagamandala or Adibak, or our Chandrasekhar Kambar. No, mainly, he also writes, but mainly the Indian mind itself, they are phalanx. That's why Bharatamani rightly says that there is a many form of theater. One is Natyadani, other is, you know that, your theater name itself is there, Lokadharmi, Natyadharmi. So these are all the two, we have to integrate with these two words, and there are subculture also there in India. That's why I'm very proud as an Indian. We have a lot of culture, lot of languages to learn. Yeah, I don't know Assami, but I know the cult. What in 17th century, Bhakti cult created the theater, the Ankian art. Very Madhuli, I did my NST second experience production based on Ankiya Bhavan. I did Kinglier. The Kingler is Assami Kinglier, not the Elizabethan Victorian era of Shakespeare. So, we have to make Shakespeare our own now. So thank you. If there is any question, I can answer it. Thank you, Chandradasan, and overall listening my long deliberation. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Basu, for coming and talking about very broadly about the repertory theatre tradition of Karnataka. So I think, you know, people can just come in and ask, comment or add or something like that. We can have some 10, 15 minutes for the discussion. Please.
Hello, Basu.
Oh, hello, sir. Hello.
Basu, this is Jolly. Nice to hear you, Basu, after a long time. And also, it is very interesting that Basu defies every time period. That is why his place has from Madari Mada is 2 hours, 40 minutes, and
his
place 9 hours. So his talk also can go
Yeah, one more 9 hours I'm going to give it there for my audience.
No. Oh my God. And that's good, but that is good. No, no. What I'm trying to say, Basu defies times. So it is different. It was very interesting to hear that, you are clearly saying that doing theater itself is a politics, and what we are doing is cultural politics, and theater should be metaphoric, and theater is highly plural. So very wonderfully saying. So I just wanted to, really just reiterate that thing. Otherwise, there is no questions. And I know that you can speak so many things about the repertories, because you are part of the repertories.
Yeah.
And you are also know that there are non-functional repertories in Karnataka also. So you know all the politics and nitty-gritties of that repertory movement. So thank you, nice hearing you. And someone else will ask. Thank you so much for coming.
One more, Johnny, for your information. Yeah. Our drama department is also starting repertory companies nowadays.
I know.
Drama department. That is the academic level also, they need practice now.
Yeah, that's true.
Obviously, all the university performing units, they really do the syllabus work, question theories and everything. There is no practical. Now at least all the departments started the practical stuff.
I know. Nagesh is planning it.
The one more thing, we have a performing university, in Karnataka, Gangubayan.
I know, Nagesh. Nagesh is there.
He's the VC there. And we have Sanskrit University. And one more university they started regarding folklore university, nowhere in the world.
I know.
That's why government always, we demand, they will create, because the public space is lesser nowadays. Everything else is a privatization is going on. So that's why in Canada, we are very much conscious. The public institution is the most important, because we can have a queries and discussion with them directly.
Yeah. That you said clearly, without public money, there is no public repertoire. Yeah. You are very, very clear. That is very interesting. Thank you, Basu. Thank you.
Thank you, Adil.
All right.
So, anybody else? Some of us, you want to say something?
She's mute. She's mute.
It's mute. No. It's not audible.
No, we cannot hear you, Soma. No.
Am I audible now?
No, audible.
No audible?
Yeah.
I'm audible?
Yes.
Yes. No, actually, I was so much, I just came to know that about the thought you have shared, that I have an experience here in Kolkata. We have done a play, mime play. It was a form of Jatra. It was taken from the form of Yatra. You know that.
Yeah,
please allow me to say something, because you were so much great person to me, and I'm so much honored. And I'm telling about it, that the place was a dalan, that means a palace, this north culture of our Kolkata or West Bengal is very rich, was very rich. And it was the concept that we are now living in nuclear, the flat culture or whatever. So the theater festival was like that we have to be together with the dalan and the what I say, jo hum zamindar ke jo ghar hote hain wahan pe jaake hum ek saath reh sakte hain ya fir hamare jo parivar hai wo ek saath ikatthe rahe. So we have used the places, we have used the stairs, we have used the balconies, we have used the ground place and the where the puja, Durga Puja is very famous, jahan pe wo puja hote hain, we have used those places for our play, for our mind play. And audience jo the wahan pe aise ikatthe baithe hue the, hum round karke unko bithaye the, aur they were watching that, and they were after the play वो सभी मेरे पास आए और हमें बोले कि ऐसे हम कभी सोचे भी नहीं कि ऐसे फॉर्म करके भी हो सकते हैं. सो आज आपके बात सुन के ये बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है कि हमें वो डर लग रहे थे कि वो ठीक हुआ कि नहीं हुआ. सो वी वेर सो मच यू नो वो कंफ्यूज थे हम लोग, पर आप आज आपके बात सुन के और भी अच्छा लग रहे हैं. तो और भी मैं एक बात कहना चाहती हूँ कि मार्शल मार्सो जी ने एक बहुत अच्छे, मैं उसको बहुत मानती हूँ, एक जगह पे उन्होंने कहा है कि आपके जो कला है, आपके जो आर्ट है, वो अगर आपके देश के जो ट्रेडिशंस है, इफ दैट इज नॉट यू नो उसके साथ जुड़े नहीं, तो आप वो बाहर भी नहीं ले जा सकते हैं. सो यू शुड मिक्स और यू शुड कलेक्ट द form of your you know country, the tradition you have. So thank you so much. I'm so much you know mere, I'm spellbound today.
Thank you very much. That's what the regional theater as well as the national and also international.
Yes sir. Yes.
And one more thing, why you are imitating the same western frame, westernized frame, you know, proscenium frame? That is
yes,
not
yes.
our culture, our not tradition, our Jatra
yes.
is not going to put in a frame, you know, our
that's
tamasha.
That's
what, yeah, we need. I'm not neglecting the Western ideas and everything. But why we have to demoralize our own tradition? That is my idea.
Yes. yes. So this session actually helped me a lot.
No. You can do.
So Chandradasan sir, that Lakudharmi, what is doing right now? ये बहुत ही अच्छे हैं हमारे जो हम नए हैं हम हमारे लिए बहुत ही हम आभार हैं आपके.
तोमा जी आप कहीं भी नाटक कर सकते हो लेकिन at least 100-200 years बैठने का जगह चाहिए बस. But there is no different place to perform, you know. That is the
yes.
Indian philosophy. That's why I never put my productions in Ravindra Sadan. I won't get theater. Is a nice long queue there. So I will create my phone space, site specific. So that is good danceable. Where you in a Aveli, you did the work production. That is also safe space. Don't worry.
So
real
true,
good.
Sir.
Real good. Thank
you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you so much. Pranam.
So any other questions? So I would love to ask you, you know, when we are doing a play for a repertory traveling group, especially maybe for Rangayana traveling group, not that group which is staying there in Mysore and performing every Sunday or Saturday, the group that has to travel to the remote places of Karnataka or to any other places, not just to theater festivals and urban centers. So, what are the possibilities and what are the limitations? Because you know, you may have to perform in a very small hall or an open space or with lights, with few lights, and with different kinds of audience also. So, and the play has to travel around. So, as a director of Rangayana, so what was your challenge?
No,
and
really?
Also, there's another. That's one question which I have to ask. The second question is also there. Because you know you have that great tradition, means heritage of Baba Karat. The way he does play music, the structure, the compositions, the way he do it. So since Baba Karat has taken the whole Indian theatre in a kind of great means influence, so was it a problem to shake off that and go beyond him or to think separately? So these two questions I am really interested to know. Whenever I go to Karnataka and see a play, these two questions come to my mind.
No, actually, Chandradasan, it's a good question for me also. After Baba Karat, I took over as a directorship, you know, Rangayana. But many our audience used to say that, oh, Rangayana is not moving now, last 5-6 years. Only spending money in Mysore only, like that the criticism is there. But I started traveling, taking company with 5 productions. I went to Mumbai. But you know that for the 5 productions, there's a different design, different directors for their approach is different. For the carrying out the sets and properties, I have to hire 5 lorries to take road. In trying, nobody allows to take that. So that's why Rangayana is different than Neenasam, because Neenasam have a design, their own design. That's what in their brochure usually say, that we need 30, 40 space. We will bring savings, lights, everything. And the place would be audiovisual, that's all, audiovisual. So it means Rangayana is not like that, because Baba Karan, to interact with the company theater and interact with the modern amateur theater, and also the new experiment has to come. So that's why Rangayana production always, it is not in the frame. Yeah, I know that Rustum Murata did one production for Rangayana, the peer game of Ibsen. So he designed in the space we couldn't take in Bengaluru or any village. So that is the easy format for Neenasam. They have a design, the simplest design. If the director goes in, they simply say that this is our design, you have to. Yeah, one more best production also is Neenasam, that Shankaran did that the water station. Within the space also, they, yeah, it's a wonderful production. It's a, no dialogue at all in the play. But the people reacted well. I witnessed it in the Mysore, in the big cartoon. So like that, the design itself differentiates the company. The Rangayana is facing that we won't impose any director, do for the frame only. If you come, you know, that's what Hippolytus, when he did for our Rangayana, he took open space. The actor came from 203 meters, you know, with the fire. But in America, La Mama company, we couldn't put. But he wants sand, you know, where you take sand for New York. So very that cost is really thousands of rupees above. Lacks together, money you have to spend. So it means the repertory means you have to give the freedom for director, the designer. The mind is the director, is the mind important, you know, how you want to design the asset. So that is the difference with Rangayana. And so we can't imitate Neenasam. Neenasam as a program, they have definitely, Neenasam can't put 50 shows the same production in Egos, because their capacity is less. Only 300 families were there. From Sagara, nearby village they come. But in Rangayana, it's not like that. It is a village as well as city also. Subordinating district they will come. That's why in Rangayana, when productions went on, it goes on 70, 80 shows in Mysore itself. So sometimes they tour. But that is also the comment we are getting from the public. Neenasam moving, why not Rangayana? Why it's happening in Mysore only? So that's why when I did my Malayalam level main house play, it can travel anywhere with the use. So it is there. If the government is funding for Dasara 10 crores for 9 days, why not for the production 1 crore? That's my argument. The unsent program, people are sending money, public money. So why you're making, we are all very dreamers, very good dreamers. Without dream, I can't fly. So why should I dream small things? So it is there, one module is there in front of mine. My vision and my theater is entirely different. Yeah, I know there is a criticism. I won't care. So I have also many people I can also criticize. So one more thing, second question. So B.V. Kanath is a great master. One thing, when I put my production Kusum Bale, Baba Karan declared, yeah, our repertory training has finished. Kusum Bale versus is the first repertory production. Yeah, we brought 5 productions to Bengaluru, first Makam. We selected 5 theaters. Raghunandan Place one is there. He is the SRMC, one of the great productions. And Bhumi Gita, Gopakrishna is the modernist poet, Adiga. Gopakrishna Adiga, Bhumi Gita. That poetry name itself we kept for the theater, you know, Bhumi Gita indoor theater in Rangayana. That is the experiment, you know. Jaitiv Joshi did it. But we selected in Bengaluru another theater. And my play is the open space, Chitrakala Parishad. So Karanth brings 5 productions. Later on, Chandra also and Jaitiv Joshi, we planned it earlier. But when we put in Bengaluru for the first 5 shows, after 2 shows, first production, we wouldn't get the audience. They came, all the 1,000 people, first day they came. Second day, there is no audience for that. So in second Bhumi Gita, where we did 60 shows non-stop in Mysore, whereas in Bengaluru, we couldn't complete even 3 shows. The audience, second day itself, the less, 20, 30 members. So So then I applied, oh my goodness, my production, what is going to be happening? The first two production, 10 days festival, he reduced to the 5 days only, and my turn is came for Kusum Bharat. Karant also nervous, I also nervous, I'm putting myself. I thought that, oh, 10 days is there, after 5 days, Raghunandan Joseph, my production is going to be happening. But Karanti announced that, no, you have to put Kusum Bharat. It's people didn't appreciate here. But whereas Mysore, we didn't 50-60 shows, the same production. So when I put my Kusuma Bale, 5 shows only earlier, the 5 show is also later on 10 doors, up to 22 shows, we non-stop shows is happened. Even our, that time, the CM of Karnataka, Mr. Ramakrishna Hegde, came to watch the production. The day it's houseful, there is no chair at all. Baba Karan told, no, it's, you are late, 10 minutes late, production started. There is no sit, what you do? No, I will sit in a carpet, don't worry. The CM sat in a carpet, which is cultural minister MP Prakash. Finally, Hegde appreciated Karanji. We are very, very lucky. What you take on 5 years, we find very good artists. So forget Bhopal Rangamandal, do it what you want. So that kind of minister also should know, na? So that was the Rangayana when government changes. The cultural minister says, CM says, their understanding regarding theatre and culture is different. That's why Bivikaran, he couldn't interact with the bureaucracy. So somehow, with my experience working with Baba Karan and the Prasanna and Bhumet, I know how to tackle the bureaucracy. So I mobilize, but I do what I want. That's why Rangayana, in my vision, had a good production and we got many productions. That's why Gandhi Vatsas got, that time I got 8 lakhs, but I spent just 2 lakhs only. I saved 6 lakhs, I given the bonus for our artist. That time, when I joined as a director, artist royalty is just 1,700 rupees. I raised it to 3,000. Later on, after 5 months, I made it 5,000. Then I asked government, no, I can't pay the royalty for the artist. The government should pay the salary. You need not to pay my productions, I will mobilize with the audience. So that is the strategy I applied. But with the influence of Vivekananda, my theatre is different. My music is different. So that's why Vivekananda is like a big banyan tree. I know that. But everybody can exercise their own ideas. That is Vivekananda. That was in Egoda also the dream. They were imposing for the selection play. But they were simply say, this is the design. We have to accommodate there only, for the Kirgata only, not for the school production. So that is the limitation, you know. No one completes here. Nobody. Do you think industry is a complete? It's representing entire Indian culture? I won't think so, you also won't think so. So that's why Abhir Tanvir is there, Kavalam Panikkar is there, Ratan Tiam is there, one side, and other side, Savitri Jai's great artists also there, na? So Bhupal Rangman also there, na? So this is a mixture of, you have to react our time with imaginary level, with poetic manner. That's what I learned in Kannada theatre and repertory.
Yes.
So that's why, you know, your last 5 years, if I know I'm going to stay in the NST 5 years, I could have rebuilt it. I started repertory without asking even government of India. With negotiating with different governments, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, I could start 20. So this year, somehow, they're starting repertory. It's going to be different repertory now. 4 language students were there. It's going to be multilingual. And there will be a Malayalam play, Telugu play, Tamil play, and also Kannada play. And see the repertory. If you compare with industry repertory, they are just Hindi play. Ratan Tiam's only Manipuri, but whereas Bangalore is different. But in Kannada, Neenasam is doing that. Ancient Kannada is there, Sanskrit play is there, Western play is there, as well as Kannada also. That is their formula. Rangayana also following the same thing. Rangayana never impose any director, do the same thing. So that kind of freedom expression is there in our state. Even religious matter, civil center also won't impose it. The only one play, they will select later 2 plays, they give to the director only. There I did the Oedipus Rex. 3,000 people witnessed Oedipus Rex in a village. After the show, there was a 3-4 hours discussion, interaction. I told, no discussion after the play, said Swamiji. Or they were, Rasabang ho jata hai, mat kariye. Leave the audience, carry the emotions, you know, what the artist left in the stage. So that's what. Yeah, I think I answered your question.
Yeah, yeah. But now Rangana is also touring. Rangana has a junior team that tours.
Yeah, they were traveling now. They were traveling.
I did the production for them.
Yeah, yeah, I know that. I know that. Everybody appreciating that production. You are also a career devotee. Yeah, it's like a repetitive production. We need dust, bucks, state of Dasal. The people were, the problem is that always final production. I want to repeat our production, but the COVID decided. Otherwise, it will go another 10, 15 shows. So that is the problem with the institution, I can't help it. And every month we have to send the budget, that what NSK has. Every month we have a budget. So I can't plan in a year as a whole. That is also there. There is a limitation.
Okay, anybody else with anything else? And this discussion will be available in YouTube and Facebook pages. We are building up our YouTube channel with the discussions we have and also with some of our productions being seen there. So you can visit it in the YouTube. It's named Logadharmi Theatre Kochi. That's the name of the YouTube channel. So it's there. So we'll be uploading it shortly, this talk. So more people will be seeing it and responding to that. So with this, I may say we have to leave today. Thank you, Basu, for coming back and talking. And thank you, everybody. And
thank you, Chandradasan. For me also, I'm recovering all my past 40 years experience, I don't know whether it is very academic or not.
No. It's experience. It's very experience and it describes the whole perspective of doing theater and what's happening around.
Many of the names I couldn't take. There were many small repetitive semi companies were there, but I couldn't. Mainly I focused on four institutions: Neenasam, Rangayana, Saniyali, and these, And even every individual they have a. Yeah. And one more thing, Prasanna, first time he started the repertory, Janapada repertory. But it's 1 year, it's finished. The final, Prasanna, he also, he won't stick on one. Now he's a. He turned as a Gandhian, he running his Charaka movement, like that.
Yeah.
So, but that is there. His philosophy is there in Karnataka theater with Samudaya. Because I came from Samudaya, I know it's a pluralist, some culture. Yeah, that. But I'm very thankful, given by the Dias, national level one, many people really they listen my talk. I don't know whether it is academically. I went to the any university, We are theatre practitioner, which practically we start with the actors only. But this is the first, in a seminar in my mother tongue, I'm comfortable, but first time also giving lecture on English. That is also a little bit discomfort for me. Thank you.